Hello and welcome back to another video with me, Philip Carhassan, for Therapy in London. Now today I want to discuss another topic which I highlighted in my video a couple of weeks ago on 5 reasons you're lacking motivation. Do you find you put things off? Do you find that you think you have ample time to do everything and then you're rushing at the last minute? You end up either not doing it or not doing it in the best possible way you can. You're rushing it. It almost seems easier to leave it and just rush and just get it done in the last minute, the last couple of seconds, and it's done, tick off the list, and it's off your plate. But what effect is that actually having on your emotional and mental well-being? Because it's almost like that gremlin, that little thought in the back of your mind, it's always there saying, oh, you better do that essay, you better read that book, you better do that project. And it's always that it's niggling away at you all the time. And actually, it can be quite detrimental to everything else you're doing in the day because you're not really concentrating on anything fully because you're actually concentrating on that task, or rather not doing that task. You're trying to run and run and run away. If you actually just did the task, just think of the relief. Just think of how good it could be. It's almost like a plaster. If you get your plaster and you rip it slowly off, it hurts and it lingers there, that pain. Whereas if you just get the plaster and rip it off in one go, okay, the pain will be more acute. It will hurt for a second, but then it will subside. And it's off your plate, it's off your mind, it's off your body. If it's a plaster, it's just gone. And by procrastinating and delaying the inevitable, it's the same thing. Actually, what detriment is that having on your life? It's making you stressed, it's making you anxious, it's taking your mind off of things. You're trying to concentrate on one thing and you can't do it properly because you're in the back of your mind, you're thinking, oh, better do that task. What if I don't get it done? When am I going to have time to do it? And you know, you may think you have time, but what if something comes up? What happens if all of a sudden your boss gives you an extra bit of workload, or you have a family commitment which you forgot about, or they just spring it on you? If I'd have just done it a couple of weeks ago instead of watching Netflix, maybe I could have done both. So actually by doing it first, by actually doing it now, it gives us a lot more space in the future and while we're doing it to A, do the best we can, and B, it negates you rushing even more to get it done because of other arrangements, other commitments that you're expected to adhere to. Why do we procrastinate? I mean, it makes so much sense to just do it now. You know it, I know it, but yet we don't. Yet we delay it and delay it and delay it. Why? For what reason? Cognitively, we know, but is there something else going on? Maybe it's the thought of doing it brings about anxiety, it brings about tension, it brings about worry. It's almost entering into a new world where this is our task. We have to live with this task and all the baggage that it brings with it, all the hard work, all the anxiety, all the emotional pain of doing it, when really we'd rather be sitting down watching TV, having an ice cream, enjoying the sunshine. But these things need doing, but yet we stop ourselves from doing it. So actually, by delaying the inevitable, we can't enjoy the moment, we can't enjoy the sunshine, because in the back of our mind, we're thinking, oh, I should be doing this work, I should be doing that, I should be doing this. Imagine having the space in order to enjoy being in the sunshine, eating that ice cream, without that thought in the back of your mind always reminding you what you've got to do, always there, always tainting the great times you're sharing with your family, your friends, or in fact, just on your own, just being you watching Netflix. There's nothing wrong with enjoying yourself, but maybe do the things you ought to do. Do the things that are gonna aid you to begin with. So A, they're done. B, they're done to the best of your ability. And C, they don't taint your life away from them. It keeps you bound within the tension. It's always there, it's ever present. It taints your life. We've got to go through a little bit of turmoil. We've got to go through a little bit of stress and do it now, right now, rather than waiting and waiting and waiting and then having to rush it at the last second. So something I want to leave you with this week is to think about what task you've been procrastinating with. So why have you not done that task? What is it that seems so hard, so unmanageable? Maybe think about doing it now, right now. I'll tell you what, turn the video off. Start. Pull that plaster off. You can do whatever you want. You can achieve your goals. If you put the hard work in, why don't you start that task right now? Switch this video off and go and do it. Be motivated, be driven. I wish you all the best. If you've got any questions which you would like answering, please do leave them in the comments down below. And I'll see you next week. Have a great day. Take care. Bye-bye.